An Iraqi ambassador says Iraq would prefer to work with the United States, but is being forced to reach out to other countries as the U.S. has been slow to send relief. Iraq is asking Iran for advice on how to combat the Sunni militants. Iran has also experienced violent attacks from the insurgents during involvement in the Syrian civil war. Meanwhile, Russian fighter jets are offering air support. Saudi Arabia has also donated $500 million to the UN to help the nearly 100 million Iraqi refugees. But some experts say such alliances could raise risks for the U.S., as some of its main global opponents consider joining forces. The Iraqi ambassador has urged the U.S. to launch targeted airstrikes, a move President Obama has held off on but not disregarded. The U.S. has ruled out sending combat troops to Iraq amid fears of joining another war. However, about 750 troops have been sent to offer counterterrorism advice to Iraqi officials. General Martin Dempsey says the goal is to assess whether Iraqi forces can stand up to the militant group.
Will they hold? What's their makeup? Are they still a force that represents all Iraqis? Are their leaders confident that they can do the jobs they're being asked to do? And then, when we have that assessment in hand, we'll make some decisions about whether there's other kinds of support that we could provide.
Washington has sold more than $10 billion worth of military equipment and weapons to Baghdad. While plans to send U.S. fighter jets have been stalled, a State Department spokeswoman said some may be delivered this fall. Jennifer Franco, One America News.